guys look natural.
Why are you sitting like that? No reason.
Is this how I normally do it? This is how I sit. This is how I sit.
Why are you sitting so strange? All right, so here we are. Let's do that.
Yeah.
Take two. GuitCon 2018. I'm here with the one and the only Adam Neely.
How are you? Yeah, I'm doing great, man.
So, first of all, thank you for making the time to come sit down, hang out.
Yeah, that's what this whole thing's all about.
Yes. And,
yeah.
Indeed. So, one of the things I thought would be fun for us to talk about, for them to enjoy, you live in New York City.
I do, yeah.
Now I live in New Jersey.
Right.
I'm a New Yorker living in New Jersey.
Right.
Born in Brooklyn, grew up in Staten Island, 28 years there. But I think New York offers a lot to a musician. So I'd like to explore with you what makes New York so great for a musician.
Yeah, well, I mean, the way I can tell you, like when I moved to New York in 2010, and I moved there because I really wanted to play jazz music. I was obsessed with jazz music and I really wanted to, be part of the scene. Mm-hmm. And from everything that I had heard, that's where you go to play. Mm-hmm. And, that's where the musicians are. And you can go to the, go to the West Village on any given night, and at the 55 Bar, there's Wayne Krantz playing, there's Mark Giuliano playing, there's all these great jazz musicians that I had seen in magazines, and mm-hmm. they were just there. That's just where you would go. And, for me, that was why I initially moved, was to be in that very inspiring environment mm-hmm. so that I could see people that were doing it really, really well all the time. Mm-hmm. And I think New York's pretty special for that reason, is that everybody is always there mm-hmm. and it's just a very inspiring environment okay. more than anything else. Yeah. I mean, is that how you've seen the scene or like?
Well, I'm not a jazz guy and go to jazz clubs, which is why I'm asking you, because you provide some insight and you're a much better musician than I will ever be. So that's why I asked you the question. I think New York City is great. And this is some of what we were talking about at breakfast.
Yeah, yeah.
You have Broadway, right?
Yeah,
it's like
yeah.
a mecca just for performing arts when you think about that. Some of the things I've seen on Broadway that I love is Rock of Ages.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I recently saw School of Rock. I was telling you that at breakfast.
Yeah.
And it just seems like just such a fun place to be if you're into the performing arts,
Yeah, and well, you mentioned Broadway. That's a very if you want to be a working musician, mm-hmm. So many of my friends are playing in off-Broadway shows mm-hmm. or Broadway shows. I briefly recorded a couple of off-Broadway albums. I was in that sort of theater scene mm-hmm. for a while, mm-hmm. and it's just a great, very fun and positive environment for musicians to, find work, mm-hmm. Play, and, it's just very inspiring. I don't want to keep saying that
sure.
word over and over and over
yeah.
again. Very inspiring place to be. And I think the downside of that, mm-hmm. of having so much there is mm-hmm. that, there might not be as much work for everybody to go around.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of a trade-off of being like really inspired by everybody that you're seeing and also knowing that maybe it will take a while to develop the network to really like make a living there and mm-hmm. really like be part of the scene in a way that you can sustain yourself, because it is very expensive to live there.
And that's
live
a good
there.
Point
yeah.
because yeah. you actually raise a good point. I think it's easy for anyone to be a starving musician.
Oh, it's very easy to be that. But
so how
you
do
don't
you,
want to do that.
How do you, and you said earlier, you moved to New York. You mm-hmm. you chose to move to New York. So why New York amongst anywhere else you could have chosen to move? And when you got there, how did you find work?
Well, yeah, I mean, the reason is because it was a very, that's where, and historically, that's where you go
okay.
if you're a jazz
yep.
musician, at least in the States. You go to New York for whatever reason.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And when I initially moved there, I had a scene from my alma mater, Berklee College of Music. There's some mm-hmm. people who also moved at the same time, so mm-hmm. I could, find work and talk to them, and they're my kind of support system, and a big mm-hmm. part of it is just having a support system, having a lot of people who are
sure.
in the same boat who are also starving with you.
Yeah.
Also right. teaching. Teaching is a big part of it
okay.
In terms of everybody wants to learn how to play guitar.
Mm-hmm.
So for the first couple of years, I taught people how to play Blackbird on guitar, and I taught people how to play Green Day on guitar,
mm-hmm.
and everybody always wants to do that. People also take jobs like odd jobs, like bartending gigs and nanny jobs and all these different ways of sustaining yourself so that eventually you can do music full time. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And it takes a while. And that's what I say to people. And that's what somebody actually told me. It takes 5 years from moving from someplace else to New York City before you feel like you are a part mm-hmm. of it in some real meaningful way. And I also have a lot of native New Yorker friends, and mm-hmm. they'll say, like, you know, I've been there for 8 years, and like, oh, no, you're not a New Yorker. It takes at least 20 years to be a New Yorker.
Sure.
So yeah, that's kind of how I approached it. For me, it took me about 5 years before.
So when you were in Berkeley, how long into that did you know you wanted to be in New York? Was that part of the plan all along, or did you figure that out along the way?
That was definitely part of the plan. I moved there for graduate school, and so I got a degree in jazz from New York. That was part of the plan for sure, mm-hmm. for sure. I knew that's what I wanted versus other cities, LA or Nashville or going anywhere else. It was very, very much always part of the plan.
Got it.
Yeah.
Anything else you could share with someone about New York? Maybe someone that wants to move there or explore music there? Any tips or tricks you could share?
If you're going to New York, don't worry about pizza. Pizza is a great thing to get anywhere. Go to Two Bros if you're starving. That will you can get two slices of pizza for $2. Good deal. Also, go to Rockwood Music Hall as much as you can. Free music. You don't have to buy any drinks. That's another free way of just meeting a lot of people. Go to Rockwood Stage Zero. That's where all the stage musicians hang out afterwards.
Where is that?
Rockwood Stage. Well, Rockwood is in the Lower East Side. And okay. It's a fairly new music venue that everybody plays at.
Okay.
I sing Rockwood's praises all the time because that's where I go and hang out with people that I play.
Okay.
And so just in terms of meeting people, that's mm-hmm. a good place to go if you want to develop a network. It's going to the shows and going and meeting people that way. If you don't have any sort of built-in network, you
sure.
go there. That would be a big piece of advice. Also, get a teaching job. Get a teaching job because people always want to learn how to play music, and that's a good way of sustaining yourself.
Awesome. There it is. Adam Neely, GuitCon 2008. Thank you so much.
Yeah, man. Thanks for...
I enjoyed the chat.
Of course.
You want to leave everyone off with one of those bad boys right there? All right. We'll see you later. Thanks, man.
Yeah.
That was a lot of fun.